What is a year? The short answer is 365 days. The slightly longer answer, mhem, a year is the time it takes for the planet Earth to complete one orbit around the Sun. During this journey, the Earth experiences four seasons: spring, summer, fall, and winter, each lasting about 3 months. It takes approximately 365, plus a quarter day s for the Earth to make one full orbit. To keep things simple, we usually count a year as 365 days, and add an extra day every 4 years, known as a leap year. The 2024 itself is a leap year, for instance. But let's suppose you don't want to age quickly and wish for a year to be longer, giving you more time to feel fresh. Fortunately, there is a planet in this universe, a dream world, that can fulfill your desire. More importantly, this planet is not very far, only 68 light years away. If you don't have a concept of 68 light years in distance, I can tell you that it is 88% closer than the famous star Betelgeuse, 84% closer than Pleiades, about the same distance as the star Aldebaran. Did you get that? Alright, do you know GJ900b? No, you don't know, and in fact you probably shouldn't know this planet because it is a pretty new finding. Right in 2024, a study discovered a celestial object named QuIS J233531.55 plus 014219.6 as a proper motion companion to Gliese 900. This object, which we just call Gliese 900b rather than QuIS J233531.55 plus 014219.6, is a planetary mass object with 10.5 times the mass of Jupiter and a spectral type of T9. It was found to be 12,000 times Earth's sun distance away from its orbiting stars. Stars, why do I add an S here? Turns out this Gliese 900 is also very interesting because it is not one star, but three stars. Yeah, it reminds you the Alpha Centauri system, but this one looks more pretty and it consists one orange dwarf star and two red dwarf stars. Now you may ask,
Whoa, 10 times more massive than Jupiter. How can that be a planet? That's a star.
Sadly, 10 times the mass of Jupiter is indeed not a stellar mass. Even more on the spot, with the mass of 10 Jupiters you don't even have the permission to say that you are a failed star, because a failed star, also known as a brown dwarf, is at least 13 times the mass of Jupiter. Consequently, despite its impressive size, Gliese 900b doesn't even quite make the cut to be classified as a brown dwarf. It's still considered a planetary mass object, making it a fascinating and unique addition to our understanding of planetary systems. The universe is big, guys, don't think Jupiter is the king, there are a lot of beasts in the darker region of the forest. Sorry, Jupiter. Back to the planet. As of 2024, Gliese 900b holds the record for the largest observed separation of any known planet, and assuming a circular orbit, it boasts the longest orbital period. The orbital period is estimated at a mind-boggling 1,300,000 years. To put that in perspective, if you were to celebrate New Year's Eve every year on Gliese 900b, you'd only get to do it once in every 1.3 million Earth years. Talk about a long wait for the next party. Imagine trying to make a calendar just for this world. Alright, you have 474,825,000 days to write. You still want 12 months? Great, please fill 39,568,750 blanks for July. And for August. And for September. And for October, probably just 30 days a month? Excellent, give 15,827,488 names for your new months. Well, probably let's just don't do that. With such a leisurely orbit, Gliese 900b is like the ultimate procrastinator of the cosmos, taking its sweet time to get around its star. In the grand scheme of things, it's a reminder that while we rush around trying to meet deadlines, there's a planet out there that's in no hurry at all. Oh, by the way. Remember the stars are just one orange dwarf and two red dwarfs? They three adding together is still dimmer than sun. And with that distance, for this planet, the sunrise and sunset become totally meaningless because that sun would be just the same to the stars in the distant. In fact, I have calculated the figure for you. The apparent magnitude is at negative 3.2. By the way, the apparent magnitude of the sun from Earth is negative 26.7. In other words, Earth's sun looks 2.5 billion times brighter than GJ900b's sun, quote-unquote. If you come to this planet, you won't find days, there is just a permanent night sky. Distance from the star is so far away, I thought, its surface temperature would approach absolute zero, because it receives very little solar radiation. For instance, dwarf planet Eris, its distance to the Sun is roughly 100 astronomical units at maximum. The surface temperature goes to less than 30 Kelvin, minus 240 degrees Celsius. On the other hand, GJ900b is 12,000 astronomical units away from dimmer stars in comparison. But, I was wrong. In fact, its surface temperature reaches as high as 500 Kelvin, approximately 200 degrees Celsius, typical baking temperature. In comparison, Saturn, which is only 10 Earth-Sun distances from the Sun, has a surface temperature of only 100 Kelvin, a frigid minus 180 degrees Celsius. So,
what's happening?
Well, remember that the planet is 11 times more massive than Jupiter? It can't be a brown dwarf due to its mass. But its mass causes it to behave similarly to a brown dwarf. What this means is that the internal pressure of the planet is so intense that it generates a significant amount of geothermal energy. Since it's a gas giant, this heat can transfer to the surface, specifically the upper atmosphere. Also, do you believe a planet could form at a distance 400 times farther from its star than Neptune, or 25 times farther than Planet 9 in theory? Apparently, it's more plausible that the planet formed independently via a hot start process. Oh, you are asking again.
What is a hot start process?
Now, here's where things get tricky. Simply put, stars form from the collapse of large amounts of interstellar gas. Sometimes, leftover gas from star formation remains and orbits the star, forming a gas disk where planets slowly develop. However, sometimes gravitational disturbances localize this gas disk, causing rapid, localized collapse similar to the star formation process but on a smaller scale, where only planets can form. This process generates significant heat energy. Gliese 900b is only 200 million years old, so much of its heat remains trapped inside. So even the surrounding environment of GJ900b is chilling, the planet itself doesn't care at all, it has a warm heart, celebrating one birthday per 1,300,000 Earth years. Pretty cool when you think this way. Anyway, while Gliese 900b might not be a vacation destination anytime soon, it certainly adds a fascinating twist to our understanding of planetary systems. And as always, I will see you again in this year.